Hello everyone, I am Mr.P.Y.Kumbhar. Welcome to this session. Today we want to see DTH. The learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of this session, student will be able to explain the concept of DTH in multimedia communication technique. The contents of these topics are introduction, history, components of DTH, advantages and disadvantages of the DTH, and applications. The contents of these topics are introduction, history, components of DTH, advantage and applications. Introduction. DTH stands for Direct to Home Service. The Direct to Home Service is a digital satellite service. Here we use digital satellite service. It is advantageous over the analog services. The first advantage of digital satellite service over the analog service is that the noise generation in the digital is very low as compared to the analog service. DTH provides television service direct to the subscriber. Here no intermediate services to be provided. It is directly service provided to the subscriber and it is advantageous. DTH can be defined as the reception of satellite programmers with a personal dish at individual home. Now we want to see the history of the DTH. The DTH was firstly invented by Sir Arthur Clarles Clark. He is a British inventor in the late 1946. The DTH services was first proposed in India in 1996, but due to the certain national security reasons, it will be not approved in the 1996. But finally in 2000, DTH service was allowed, and after that one, Doordarshan was the first service to provide to the consumers. Now we want to see the components of the DTH. The components of the DTH are first, this one satellite, second broadcasting centers, third multiplexers, fourth modulators, and fifth encoders. Now we want to see this one by one, the components of the DTH. Now this figure 2 shows the block diagram of the DTH. Now detailed block diagram we want to understood by one by one. Now see, first here television channel or station where the programs will be the recorded. After that one, it will be the uploaded through the satellite, and after that one, it will be the downloaded towards this DTH provided companies. And here we encryption technique is used as MPG2. After that one, when we receive the signals into the DTH, DTH will provide the signal to the consumer by, with the help of, first of all, it will upload the program through the satellite, and it will be the downloaded into the DTH receiver, which is located on the home or the office. After that one, when we receive the signal, it will go to the set-top box, and after that one, it will go to the different procedure, that is modulation and demodulation techniques, that will be the receive on these TV channels, and consumer will see that all these programs. Now we want to see one by one, that is out of that one, first one is satellites. Before going to these satellites, everyone pause the video and recall what is meant by the satellite. Okay, now satellite means it will be the transmit as well as receive the signals from the earth station or to the earth station. Here in the satellites, mainly for the DTH, we use a geostationary satellite. Therefore, a geostationary satellite plays an important role in the DTH system. Each satellite is launched into the space at about 7,000 mile per hour, that is if we convert into the kilometer per hour, that is 11,000 kilometer per hour, reaching approximately 22,200 miles, that is 35,700 kilometer above the earth. It is the location of the geostationary satellite which is used for the DTH system. Therefore, in India, DD Direct and DISH TV transmission service are from NSS-6 satellites. Now when we use NSS-6 satellites, then there's Specification are also important for this NSS-6 satellites. Now everyone observes this specification of NSS-6 satellites, and we, after the observation of this NSS-6 satellites, here we use number of Ku band transponders is 60, and here modulation type we use as a QPSK. And one more important thing for this one, uplink and downlink frequency. That uplink frequency is 30.75 to 14.5 gigahertz, and the downlink frequency range is 10.95 to 12.75. In that one, we use different frequency band. Now we want to see broadcast center. The broadcast center is the central hub of the system. In the broadcast center, here what will happen? Here we can take the programs and transmit the programs. Here at the broadcast center, the television provider receives the signals from the various programming source and broadcasts the signal to satellites in geostationary orbit. The satellite receives the signals from the broadcast station and rebroadcast them to the ground. After the rebroadcast to the ground, the DTH will receive that signal and to provide with the help of different operations we want to see on the TV channel. Next, multiplexer. A multiplexer is a device which transmits the information of many channels into one channel and transmit it to the geostationary satellite. After that geostationary satellite, it will again transmit towards the DTH antenna. The multiplexer is built in the broadcasting center. It sends the signal channel to the modulator. Again, now we want to see the next one is modulator. Modulation is a process in which the information signal is imposed on a carrier signal which is of a high strength. Here, very high strength signals we require for transmission of this information. The modulator modulates the signal and sends to the encoder. Now we want to see what is the means of encoder. The encoder encodes the signals to transmit the signals. The satellite sends the signals to the DTH antenna. The antenna transmits the signals to the set-top box. After that set-top box, it will given to the TV channels with the help of different modulation and demodulation techniques that we'll see on the TV. The other components of the DTH are, first, DTH antenna. Second, LNB, and third one is set-top box. Now we want to see one by one, that is first DTH antenna. Here antenna is used most of the important part because transmitter as well as receiver part is done in this antenna. The reflector surface material must be constructed out of the metal in order to reflect the incoming microwave signals. Here, for transmission as well as the receiver, we use microwave signals. Some antenna reflectors appear to be manufactured out of plastic or fiberglass. Here in the antenna, we use one of the reflector that will reflect whenever all the signals when I will get on this antenna, that will be reflect to the LNB and we get these signals. The solid one piece metal antenna is most of the always the dish. Because the no assembly errors, and reflector normally will maintain its precise shape over the lifetime of the system. Therefore, we use here solid one-piece metal antenna. Here, antenna specifications are provided in this table, and here are the different parameters and their respective values are provided for the standard DTS system. Now, we want to see LNB. LNB means low noise block down converter. It is one of the most important part in the DTS system. It is available over the reflector part. Now, the incoming satellite signals propagates down the waveguide of the feed horn. A tiny resonant probe is located on the LNB. Whenever this resonant probe is used because maximum energy we can utilize here. Due to this maximum energy utilization, the errors will be less and noise will be the less. Therefore, the internal noise contribution of the LNB is amplified. After the amplification of this noise, whenever we internal noise will be the amplified, then noise will be the removed easily. Therefore, the internal noise contribution of the LNB is amplified along with the incoming signal and passed on the succeeding amplifier stage. And after that succeeding amplifier stages, the noise will be the removed. Now this table provides the LNB specifications. These are the different parameters and the respective values for this LNB specifications. Now set-top box. Set-top box accepts the entire down converted band. It separates out the individual transponder frequency. Signals are first converted to fixed intermediate frequency and then it transmits to the QPSK demodulated. Again, after that one, the bit stream is processed and to detect and correct the errors. Again, here we use a digital demultiplexer. In the digital demultiplexer, first it will extract the bits for wanted channel. It sends them to the MPG decoder. Finally, generates the analog audio and video signals with DIA converted to the drive TV set. The advantages: first, cost-effective communication, information, and entertainment to all. Second, small size terminals can provide up to 4000 TV channels and 2000 radio channels. DTS service bypasses mediators and thus content provider comes with customers directly. The applications: first, to view pay and free to air TV channels of various DTS platform on your home TV. Doordarshan free to air service providing 40 TV channels with no subscription fees. One can scan the entire globe with a motorized dish using a CI setup box with the CAM modules. The references for these topics are. Thank you.